Okay, so let's start today's class. In previous class, we are studying about introduction of artificial intelligence, in which we have discussed about data, information, knowledge, and wisdom. What was data? Data was raw facts and figures. What is information? Information was process data. And what was knowledge? When you understand that information, which you have got from many resources, like by any person, by your experience, or by any other means. When you understand that information, it will become your personal knowledge. And what is wisdom? Wisdom is what? When you are able to understand how to apply that gained knowledge, then you are in the wisdom state. Okay, so this is the backbone of your artificial intelligence, because here we require data, because without data we cannot make a machine intelligent. As human beings, we are having enormous data from throughout our life, from many resources, from our environment, from our teachers, from our parents, from our friends. We are having enormous data in our brain and with our perception, with our previous understanding of any situation. We have some experience, and based upon that experience, we take decisions about a new situation we are having in our life. Or we are having any other problem, we solve based upon our previous experience. Experience is what? Your observations. Experience is what? Your observation that in previous situation, when something happened, then what will be the outcome? So if in future similar situation will come, then what will be the outcome? Okay, so let's see. We have discussed what is artificial and what is intelligence. Let me revise. What is artificial? Made or produced by human beings rather than occurring naturally, especially a copy of something natural. Therefore, in short, we can say something that is not natural, that is man-made. If something is made by a person or man, then it is not natural thing. And what is intelligence? The ability to acquire and apply knowledge and skills. Therefore, intelligence means rational mental faculties. Rational mental faculties means, rational means you have a power of reasoning. Mental faculty means power to solve in a reasonable manner to solve a problem. So therefore, artificial intelligence is the study of how to make computers do things which at the moment people do better. This is the definition coined by Rich and Knight in 1991. So let's move on. Let's think how a machine can think intelligently. So there is a one point of view by Bellman in of 1978. He says that thinking like a human, if a machine is able to think like a human, then we can say machine is intelligent. The definition provided by Bellman is the automation of activities that we associate with human thinking. If something that we relate with human thinking can be done by machines, then we can say that machine is thinking like a human. This is the definition provided by Bellman in 1978. And there is another point of view about artificial intelligence. It's coined by Kurzweil in 1990. He said that if a machine act like a human, then we can say he is possessing the power of intelligence. The definition provided by Kurzweil is the art of creating machines that perform functions that require intelligence when performed by people. He is simply saying that if something can be done by a machine which is done by the humans, which required intelligence, like driving a motor car, right? It required intelligence that how you drive in a very busy road or where to turn your car. It required intelligence. If that thing is done by automated machine, then we can say that a machine is intelligent. Another point of view is that humans are always not act rationally. It means they are some person having a different mental faculties and other persons having a different mental faculties. So the another point of view says that if a machine, people are coming so late in our class, disturbing us. Okay, so next thing is thinking rationally, said by Charnwick and McDormand in 1985, the study of mental faculties through the use of computational models. He is saying that if we study the mental faculties through the use of computational models, means if we can drive a computational model which can mimic the mental faculties of human being, then we can say that machine is thinking rationally. Rationally means logically. If a machine is able to reason, is able to give some reasoning about why some output is given, then we can say that machine is thinking rationally. And another point of view is, if a machine is acting rationally, given by Lujan in 2002, the branch of computer science that is concerned with the automation of intelligent behavior. That is, if the artificial intelligence is a branch of computer science that is concerned with the automating the intelligent behavior of human beings and giving that intelligence behavior to the machine, so that machine can act rationally, means machine can perform things logically, that how a machine should act if a person is able to solve that particular problem. So let's move on. The branches of artificial intelligence, according to Association of Computing Machine, what are the branches of artificial intelligence? First one is general AI, which include cognitive modeling, philosophical foundation. Cognitive means what? Can anyone tell me what is the meaning of cognitive? Maninder, are you there? Can you explain the term cognitive? Maninder, are you there? Please unmute yourself and explain the meaning of word cognitive. Maninder, are you there? Maninder, are you sitting with your computer or mobile or having your breakfast or something else? Maninder, am I audible to you? Okay, Maninder is not responding. So, Anurag, are you there? Anurag Dubey, are you there? Please unmute yourself and explain the meaning of word cognitive. Okay, he is also not responding. Anyone wants to give his point of view or her? Mansi, are you there? Mansi,
Yes, sir.
can you explain the word cognitive? What is the
No,
meaning of cognitive?
no
No
idea,
idea.
sir.
Okay.
No.
You can mute yourself. Divya, are you there? Divya, can you explain the term cognitive? Divya,
Yes, sir.
what is the meaning of cognitive?
Sir, I have no idea about this word.
Okay, no issue. Ayush, are you there? Ayush,
Yes, sir.
can you explain the meaning of word cognitive?
No, sir, I don't know.
Yes.
I don't know, sir, actually.
Okay, you also don't know. Let me explain then. Cognitive means what? It is related to your psychology. Cognitive means the process of knowing something. Cognitive means the process of knowing something. What? How you are able to understand things. This comes in the cognitive science. Means the like we have psychology things are there. Like you understand how our mind understand things. These kind of studies come under cognitive science. So cognitive is the process of knowing something, process of knowing or understanding something. So this is a philosophical foundation, that is a general AI cognitive modeling, philosophical foundation. Next one is expert system and applications. Third is automated programming. Fourth is deduction and theorem proving. Fifth is formalism and methods of knowledge representation, means how you represent your knowledge. Anurag Dubey has written cognitive means new thinking. It's not about new thinking, it's about understanding how you are thinking or knowing something else about or around you. Next is machine learning, understanding and processing of natural and artificial intelligence, problem solving, control methods, and state space search, robotics, computer vision, pattern recognition, scene analysis, and distributed artificial intelligence. These are the branches of artificial intelligence which is recognized by the Association of Computing Machinery. Means these all things comes under the artificial intelligence. The thing is, everything which comes under the human beings' mind umbrella that we have to give to the machine. Then only we can say that machine can able to reason things as a human being can reason. So let's have a difference between cognitive science and artificial intelligence. As we have seen that in cognitive science, we have intelligence, we have a characteristic of intelligence. So in artificial intelligence, what we are going to do, artificial intelligence. You can think of cognitive science that is related with the humans and artificial intelligence related with the machine. So we are comparing here with human with the machine. So understand these things, that cognitive science means related to humans, artificial intelligence that is related to machine. So in cognitive science, first one is intelligence. Intelligence is what? You understand about intelligence, that what intelligence is? Able to reason a particular situation, how to solve a problem. So that thing we have to give to the machine. So we are having artificial intelligence in machine section. In cognitive science, we have knowledge, but a machine cannot have knowledge. Machine can have knowledge base. That means we have to feed all the knowledge and information to the machine. Third one is cognition, that is ability to act reasonably and understand things. And here we have information processing. Like humans have cognition and machine have information processing. Humans have learning and artificial have machine learning. Humans learning, understanding languages. Humans can learn and understand languages. What about artificial intelligence? They have natural language processing. So this is the difference between human and machine. Cognitive science is related with human and artificial intelligence related with machine. So here you can see we are comparing intelligence. With human, we are having intelligence. With machine, we are having artificial intelligence. Knowledge, knowledge base, cognition, information processing, learning, machine learning, language understanding, language, natural language processing. So what are the foundations of AI? First one is computer science. In computer science, we have machines, languages, formal theories of computation. Machines, we are talking about hardwares. Languages, formal theories of computation, mathematics, limit of computation, probability, statistics, Bayes' rules, experimental design. So for AI, we need computer science, we need mathematics, we need philosophy. Why philosophy? We need logic, epistemology, philosophy of mind, theories of consciousness, psychology, cognitive models, human problem solving and learning, economics, decision theory, game theory, neuroscience, perception, neural models, linguistics, human language, translation, grammars, and also biology, adaptive systems, evolving system. These are the foundation of AI. Means we have to take care of all these things to put a machine intelligent. So what are the application of AI? Parent discipline of AI are philosophy, cognitive science, mathematics, psychology, computer science. These all contribute to artificial intelligence. And what are the subjects covered under AI? Reasoning, learning, planning, perception, knowledge acquisition, intelligent search, uncertainty management, and others. And what are the applications? Like game playing, theorem proving, language and image understanding, robotics, and navigation. These are some of the applications pointed out here. And next, we are having some exercise like what is artificial intelligence. This is for today's class, just for introduction. I am again revising you today's class. What we have studies, like what is artificial intelligence? Firstly, what is artificial? Made or produced by human beings rather than occurring naturally, especially as a copy of something natural. Therefore, artificial means not natural, that is man-made. What is intelligence? The ability to acquire and apply knowledge and skills. Therefore, intelligence means rational mental faculties. What about artificial intelligence? It is the study of how to make computers do things which at the moment people do better, which is given by Rich and Knight in 1991. We have four different point of view about artificial intelligence. There is no single definition of artificial intelligence which is acceptable by all universally. So we have different point of view. First one is thinking like a human. Second one is acting like a human. Third one is thinking rationally. And fourth one is acting rationally. So what is thinking like a human? It is automation of activities that we associate with human thinking. acting like a human, the art of creating machines that perform functions that require intelligence when performed by people. Thinking rationally means the study of mental faculties through the use of computational models. What is acting rationally? The branch of computer science that is concerned with the automation of intelligent behavior. Next, we think of study what the branches of artificial intelligence, which is recognized by the Association of Computing Machinery. First one is general AI, cognitive model, that is philosophical foundation, means how a human understand and approach to a problem to solve it. Second one is expert system and application, automated programming, deduction and theorem proving, formalism and methods of knowledge representation, machine learning, understanding and processing of natural and artificial languages, problem solving, control method and state space search, robotics, computer vision, pattern recognition and scene analysis, distributed artificial intelligence. Next, we have seen what is the difference between cognitive science and artificial intelligence. Cognitive science is related with the humans and artificial intelligence is related with the machine. In cognitive science, we have intelligence. Intelligence is what? Wisdom. Intelligence means you are able to understand how to apply your knowledge that you have gained. As you can see in bottom, firstly, you have understanding of languages through learning, then you have cognition, then knowledge, then intelligence. Means to achieve the intelligence, you must understand the languages, you must have learning, you must know how to solve a problem by cognition, and knowledge is what is the understanding of your information you have gained through your life. So for cognitive science, what are the characteristics? We have intelligence, knowledge, cognition, learning, and understanding of languages. And for artificial intelligence, we have to put manually this type of characteristics of human being into the machine with the help of artificial intelligence. And artificial intelligence is based upon knowledge base, information processing, machine learning, natural language processing. As you can see that artificial intelligence is not a single tool. It is a combination of several tools. Artificial intelligence is just a recipe. As the question asked by Umang, that why we are studying first artificial intelligence, why not we are starting with machine learning or data science or anything else, which are the subcomponents of artificial intelligence. So the thing is that artificial intelligence is, we are not learning actually artificial intelligence. We are learning how to achieve artificial intelligence. Means the artificial intelligence is just a container. Artificial intelligence is just a container, and we have to fill this container with multiple tools like what? Knowledge base, information processing, machine learning, natural language processing, your pattern recognition, scene recognition. These are all the tools that fill that container of artificial intelligence. So basically, we are not learning something called artificial intelligence. We cannot see something that we have created this is the artificial intelligence. That may be lie under the category of machine learning. That activity may lie under the activity of natural language processing. So these things are all our combination. When combined together, we can say that it is the artificial intelligence. So we are not learning basically the artificial intelligence. It is just a concept. Artificial intelligence is just a concept. And how to achieve that concept? We are having multiple subsections like machine learning, big data, your neural networks. These are all the tools that can combine together and can achieve the common goal, that is artificial intelligence. So in artificial intelligence, we touch all these topics superficially. And when a person can interested on a particular thing, like if I am interested in machine learning, I am interested in deep neural networks, I am interested in cognitive neural network, then there is an entire separate branch of that particular thing, and that person can go and learn those particular things separately, because each and everything, like we are having a multiple methods of knowledge base, we are having a multiple methods of information processing, these like machine learning, it is an entirely different subject as a whole. So if a person is learning about artificial intelligence, we are having touch in all these activities, little bit. When someone have some interest, we can go for that, all those things separately. So what is foundation of AI? Artificial intelligence, as you can understand, that it is the mimic of human intelligence. So how a human achieve intelligence? We achieve intelligence through learning. How we learn things? Learning is what? Understanding of particular problem, how we are solving those problems. So problems are of many types, like your professional problem, your personal problems, like you have to go to office or you have to go to university today from your home. This is a problem. How you are going to solve that problem? You may be having cycle, you may be having bicycle, you may have a car, you maybe go by walking itself, by having public transport, you are solving a problem. But by doing, by using any means, you are having some experience, you are having some learning, that if you are going for public transport, you have to pay to public transport to reach the destination, and that public transport may not be as easily available to you, maybe not from your house. You have to go to the main road to get that particular vehicle of public transport. So each and every day you are learning each and everything. Suppose you are having inverter in your house and it is having a capability to run only 5 fans. Suppose you have switched on the 6th fan also. Now the inverter is beeping, started beeping and just shut down. You got the learning that only 5 fans can run with your inverter. Whenever you switch on the 6th one, inverter is going offline. So each and every day you are learning something, you are having a lot of data from multiple resources from your mind. So this is the foundation of AI in computer science. We have machine languages, formal theories, computation, mathematics, limit of computation, probability, statistics. There are multiple rules, design on the mathematics. We need philosophy, like how we reason, how we, there is no particular, again, acceptable definition of intelligence that can universally accepted. There are multiple point of view, multiple thoughts regarding intelligence, because it is some related to philosophy. As you know that in philosophy we do not have any certain things, we have different point of view because it is related to humans, and humans are not predictable, they can do anything. If you think that you are intelligent human being, but in some situation you not perform up to the mark. So human behavior is very unpredictable. But what are the characteristics of a human that we can say that are rational? Those characteristics we want to put into the machine. So we need philosophy, like logic, epistemology, philosophy of mind, theories of consciousness, psychology, cognitive model, human problem solving and learning, economics, decision theory, game theory, neuroscience, perception, neural models. Like in neuroscience, we are talking about neural models. What are neurons? That our minds consist of a lot of neurons. We can think of neuron as the smallest unit of a memory cell that we are storing information. Just like in computer science, we are having flip-flop that can store a single bit information. We have linguistic, human language translation, grammar understanding, and in biology, adaptive system, evolving system means how a machine, how a human being can absorb things, how our body can respond to some medicines. These kinds of things are adaptive system and evolving system, how our body evolved by the time. And what are the some application areas of AI? As we can see, the parent discipline of AI are philosophy, cognitive science, mathematics, psychology, computer science. These all are contribute to artificial intelligence. And the subjects covered under artificial intelligence are reasoning, learning, planning, perception, knowledge acquisition, intelligent search, uncertainty management, and others. What is the meaning of perception? Perception means what you are having knowledge previously, you just think about. We have a pre-mindset about that particular thing, that I know that person is not able to call me on tea, or he is not able to invite me on his birthday. However, my is asking something, sir, computer can perform only logical computation, but human have intuition power and logical to solve problem. Then how computer can perform intuitional problems? The thing is, you are talking about intuitional powers. That is, you can have a gut feeling kind of thing, like you can predict things with and how you are having intuitional power. You are having intuitional power based upon your past experiences and observations, right? So this is the things we have to implement. And your intuitional power comes from here. You are having a lot of data with you. You are having a lot of like problems in that you have solved previously related to that particular thing. Suppose you are having a motor car. Now, if you know that your car is about 10 years old, and after some time, whenever you are riding your car may stop somewhere. If you press your clutch 5 to 10 times continuously, then one time that thing happened again. After some time that thing happened again, then you have an intuition that if I press my clutch 5 to 6 times continuously, then my motor car can be stopped. Now, how you have this intuition? Because you have some past experiences with you. So this is that's total a game of data. How you understand your previous data and information, how you process that information, only from there you have that intuition power. So the power of reasoning, the power of intuition power, these are things are based upon your previous experiences only. And what are the previous experiences? These are your previous data, previous information that you have gained from multiple resources. So the question is, computer can perform only logical computation, but humans have intuition power and logical reasoning to solve problems. That logical reasoning to solve that problem, like if you have seen the game of TikTok, right, in which we have some crosses and circles, you can think that you have some intuition that how a second person is going to put a cross or in which block, right? You have intuition because you have played that game a multiple number of times. You know each and every reasoning and steps how to tackle that particular problems. What about if we are having all if and buts, all cases put into the machine? Now, if all the cases and all the reasoning power I have provided the machine, then if you are playing TikTok with the machine, then machine is having all the scenarios with it already, then you can say that whatever the intuition or the logical reasoning you are having, that machine can process. So this is a problem of deep learning, means how a machine can learn from deep learning problems. A lot of things are there. This artificial intelligence things that which is in your syllabus, it is just having a feel about what are the things we can learn or what are the tools we can have in our pocket to fill that container of artificial intelligence. We will study each things one by one, and you can see that how machine can reason, how machine can provide you the ability to predict things that we have not already provided some programming for. That means a machine can learn with the previous data itself, not programmed by the humans. So there is some exercises. I will put some more questions on that. And here is some reference. So, all these books are available online. You can search this string in the Google and you can get the PDF, all those things. I will recommend this second one, Rich and Kevin Knight's Artificial Intelligence by McGraw-Hill. You all can find these books on the online. I will provide this study material on your Google Classroom. You can download this today's class lecture note from your Google Classroom. Okay, so this is the introduction part is over now. We will go for some more topics like what is the history of artificial intelligence, from where we have started and what things have already been done. These kinds of things we will discuss in next lecture. And then we will go on to study each one by one, all the tools that we are having in our syllabus. So till now, revise all those things, download all the PDF for your books that you can find, and start learning. Okay. Thank you, class. See you in the next class. Bye-bye.